Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to show you how to add special characters like Greek letters and mathematical symbols to a plot. First, we'll create a plot. Then, I'll show you how to use TeX Markup to add superscripts and subscripts, modify the text, and add special characters. Finally, I'll show you how to add an equation to the plot and use LaTeX Markup for more advanced formatting options. Let's get started. The temperature at the center of a plane wall can be described by the following dimensionless equation. Theta naught is equal to A1 times E to the minus lambda 1 squared times tau. And we're going to plot theta naught as a function of tau over the interval 0.2 is less than or equal to tau is less than or equal to 2. In this equation, the constants A1 and lambda 1 have values of 1.1191 and 0.8603, respectively. The result is going to be a plot that looks like this. The main purpose of this video is to show you how to use TeX Markup to add special characters like Greek letters and mathematical symbols to the text in a plot. I'll also show you how to use LaTeX Markup for more advanced formatting options. Let's head over to MATLAB and get started. Now that we're in MATLAB, let's open a new script file on the Home tab. Click New Script, which opens the editor. Our equation has two constants, A1 and lambda 1. A1 is assigned the value of 1.1191, and lambda 1 is assigned the value of 0.8603. Tau is our independent variable. I'm going to use the colon operator to create an array or row vector of taus. Tau is assigned the value of 0.2 is the initial value. I'm going to use a step size or incremental value of 0.01, and the final value is 2. Theta naught is our dependent variable. Theta naught is assigned the value of A1 times E to the minus lambda 1 squared times tau. So now I'm going to call the exponential function exp, and the argument to the function is minus lambda 1 squared times tau. So we have minus lambda 1 squared times tau. I'll add a semicolon at the end of this line to suppress the output to the command window, and we're ready to create our plot. I'm going to call the plot function and provide a pair of coordinates. The independent variable is tau, and the dependent variable is theta naught, and that's it. Now we are ready to save and run our file. I'm going to go to the Editor tab and click Run. I'll provide a file name of temperature plot and click Save. And MATLAB opens a new figure with our plot. Now let's take a look at how to add special characters like Greek letters and mathematical symbols to the plot. TeX is a typesetting language that is often used to format complex mathematical formulae. By default, MATLAB supports a subset of TeX Markup. TeX Markup can be used to add superscripts and subscripts, modify the font family, size, and color, and add special characters. Modifiers are used to format the text. In the table on the right-hand side, you can see the character sequences that you would enter to format the text. Modifiers remain in effect until the end of the text, with one exception. Superscripts and subscripts only modify the next character or the characters within the curly brackets. Most of the modifiers begin with a backslash. As an example, if you wanted to make a text bold, you would precede the text with the characters backslash B and F. MATLAB's subset of TeX Markup supports some special characters. I've highlighted some of the special characters in the table on the right-hand side. All of these special characters begin with the backslash character. As an example, if you wanted to insert the relational operator less than or equal to, you would insert the characters backslash LEQ. I've also included a link to a handout in the description of this video that contains a more complete list of some of the special characters that you can use. All right, let's head back to MATLAB. Now that we're back in MATLAB, let's close the figure. Before we add labels to the plot, let's add grid lines using the grid function. I'll specify grid and then on. Next, let's add a label to the horizontal axis using the xLabel function. Our independent variable is the Greek letter tau, so I'm going to insert a backslash and then the name of the Greek letter tau. Next, we'll add a label to the vertical axis using the yLabel function. Our dependent variable is theta naught. First, we'll insert the Greek letter theta, then we'll insert a subscript using an underscore of 0. Finally, let's add a title to the plot using the title function. Plot of theta naught for 0.2 is less than or equal to, tau is less than or equal to 2. And that's it. Now when I click run, MATLAB opens our figure. We've added a label to the vertical and horizontal axis and a title to the plot with Greek letters, a subscript, and relational operators. Let's add an equation to the plot, and I'm going to place this equation at tau is equal to 1.4 and theta naught is equal to 0.5. Let's close the figure and add an equation to the plot using the text function. First, we'll provide a pair of coordinates where we want to place the equation, which is at tau is equal to 1.4 and theta naught is equal to 0.5. Next, we insert a character vector with our formatted equation. Our equation is theta naught is equal to A1 times E to the minus lambda 1 squared times tau. And that's it. Now when I click run, MATLAB opens a new figure with our formatted equation, but we can improve the formatting of this equation by switching the interpreter from TeX to LaTeX. Let's take a look. MATLAB supports a subset of LaTeX markup. You can use LaTeX markup to format text in titles, axis labels, legends, and other functions that output text. To use LaTeX markup, specify LaTeX as the interpreter. To display an equation in line, enclose the markup with single dollar signs. To display an equation in display mode, enclose the markup in double dollar signs. All right, let's head back to MATLAB one more time. Now that we're back in MATLAB, let's close the figure one last time and return to the text function. This time we're going to specify the interpreter as LaTeX instead of the default of TeX. And that's it. To present the equation in display mode, we enclose the markup in double dollar signs. So I'll insert double dollar signs at the beginning and end, and that's it. So I will click run one last time, MATLAB opens up a figure again, but this time we have a properly formatted equation. All right, that's it. I hope this video provided you with a good introduction to how to use LaTeX and TeX to format an equation and add special characters like Greek letters and mathematical operators. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video and would like to see more, subscribe below. If you'd like to support the channel, consider becoming a member or check out some of the Spartan Professor merchandise available in my shop. You can find me online and on social media at David Calamus and Spartan Professor.